really nervous all of a sudden. What's going on? Hello and welcome to our first Squadcast that we're going to be calling RallyPoint. And what is this? Well, it's just a group of the regulars who play squad all the time. We're always on it 24 hours a day. And we're just going to jibber-jabber about the game, some of the features that we like, some of the things we don't like, things that are bothering the community that are on the forum quite a lot. And it's going to be a no-holds-barred. We'll tell you exactly how it is, and if you don't like it, well, it's tough. So with me is myself, Para, and we've also got in here RossyRaider, and we've also got DocEast. Say hello, you Muppets.
All right, son.
Yes.
All right. Right, so one of the first things we're going to talk about is the Steam release. What we think about it, is it a good thing? How has it changed for you two from when we were in the original founders and the backers? Has it changed for you?
It definitely has changed. Especially more so with running as a squad leader. I play almost exclusively as a squad leader majority of the time, and usually like the stuff we see, I know Rossi can back me up on this too, is the torrential downpour of the new guys. And we all expected this. So that's the main thing. We all expected this new flood of new guys coming in, kind of diluted the player base a little bit, especially with pre-alpha and close pre-alpha. A lot of us kind of, like, we'd see each other in-game all the time, and now before, like, you don't see each other hardly at all. Of course, also, private servers also kind of came in, diluted it even more, so. But,
Oh, Iron Bay is here.
Yeah.
Hey, Iron.
Oh.
Oh, you just come in town, we've just been slagging you off, saying, look at this part-time. Yeah. Just coming in late as usual, showing up, trying to take big licks. How you doing? You all right?
Hello.
Hey, how you doing? No, we're just discussing the community and how it's changed since it went from closed alpha. For me, it felt like, this is going to sound ridiculous, but it felt like we had a really close-knit little family community. And then when it went to Steam, it's like, where the fuck is everybody? It's like all the regulars that we used to see on there, they've all dispersed. And it's strange now that it's been out. How long has it been out for now? 2 weeks, is it? 3 weeks?
Yeah, 2 weeks.
Yeah.
Now I'm starting to see the regulars again because we all seem to be hanging out on certain servers, red coats.
Yeah.
So it's almost like it was a tight-knit group and I thought, I don't like it now. It's got bigger, but now I like it again because it's come back in again.
Yeah. Like I was saying before, I said it a few times in the forums as well. Like, we kind of stick close on the old school. Shit, I'd say old school like a long time ago. It was like 2 weeks ago, but pre-alpha guys and close pre-alpha guys, you know, kind of stick close. Yep.
What do you think, Rossi? You think it's changed since it's gone to open?
Oh, yeah, no doubt it's changed, but I actually don't think it's as bad as what we thought it was going to be.
I agree.
Day one, day two, day three, you know, the first couple of days were, you know, horrendous. Yep. But the next couple of days, I thought people got all right. People weren't being squad leaders without a mic. People in squad were... but not retards and doing, do you know what I mean? They were listening, they were doing things that you don't got to tell them to reload, they've done it automatically, do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
To that kind of mindset, you know?
But it was strange that a lot of people are asking, you know, when you first go into the game, there's a loading screen. I've forgotten what's on there now. Is it V for local talk, B for squad? And yet in game, people still type in, how do you talk to the squad? I've noticed that quite a lot.
And I don't know the answer because I've changed my keys.
Yeah.
So people ask me, I don't know.
How do you crouch?
I don't know why people just don't remap their keys like right off the bat. Plus, there's a training thing right there that you can just jump into. If I see the word training in the main menu when I first boot up a game, I click that. And then I look at my controls and it's like, oh, okay. I know how to move around and do this or that. And then, I don't know.
Yeah, but do you not think that even the closed alpha, it probably took me at least a month to be able to fully get my head around fobs, where you can put them, and all that.
There's the whole how the game works, but then there's how to, like, just your individual, like, input, like, how to move your guy around, how to communicate, like, how to, you know. The keys is one thing you can get day one, but it takes a while to get you wrap your head around the whole, I guess, metagame, you know what I mean? Like, how a fob works. And then once you learn how a fob works, then you move on to, well, what's a good fob and what's a bad fob and that sort of thing. And that takes a while and we're still working on that. I mean, at least in my clan, we spend a lot of time just talking about strategy and figuring out, well, what would be a better fob? What would be a better way to, you know, place one? And then we move on to things like, well, where should we place it? And then how should we leave it when we do spawn on it? You know, like, we put it right at the foot of this hill that's bare, but then there's foliage at the bottom. Don't go up the hill that's bare. They're going to see you. Yeah. You know? That sort of thing.
Yeah, that kind of stuff, too, kind of comes with experience, too, especially playing a game like you're talking about. You guys didn't quite understand that and grasp that right away, so... Like, at least the past 4 or 5 rounds I've been playing between the last 48 hours, I've had, you know, relatively new squad leads. I mean, they're competent enough to move their guys around and get some stuff accomplished, but immediately I'm seeing fobs placed all over cast, like the actual cast zones immediately.
It's all right for us because we was, you know, the first couple of guys, so we was having, what, 2 squads, so there was 2 squad leaders talking. Now, if I was to jump in it now, there's 4 squad leaders talking at me, my guys are saying, like, I want a fob, I want ammo crater, what's the next move? It's like, it's hard to jump into, man. It's like it's one of them. Like we've been there and done it, and gone
but there's still things in there where I don't know. It's like the other night when we were playing, right? All the other squad leaders were new, and because they knew I'd played before, I was getting bombarded with questions on the squad radio about where should we put the fob? Do we put it on the flag or do we put it in the woods? And it's almost like I didn't know what to answer to that because every game you're in is completely different.
Exactly. I've had games where a fob on the flag has won.
Yeah,
and I've had games where a fob on the flag has lost me the game. Like people ask me, it's like, well, I mean, you should use like see what's going on. Use your own brain, use your own knowledge, and see what happens.
Exactly.
There are little things I think the devs can help on this, such as the one game I was in with the ammo box. People were saying that this game's shit. It don't work. It's fucked. It's bugged. And what it was, they'd put the ammo box down, and they'd only shoveled it for about 10 seconds and then left it thinking...
So the first level.
Yeah, they weren't aware. I thought that they'd put messages in the game now because I've got them turned off. But little things like that, they didn't know you had to keep shoveling it, and they also didn't know that you could de-shovel enemy barriers and things like that. So maybe they could do with a tutorial at some point on this.
Well, they have tutorials out there for sure, but are you talking about like in-game?
Yeah, even if it's just, you know, the first time they go to it, there's a little, like, you know, those little pop-up messages they've got now, like F to...
the rearm,
even if it was a one-time off where you could flick the tutorial labels on or off, I think would help a lot of players.
With the red coats and stuff, obviously we try to, you know, get a guy in each squad, regardless whether he's being squad lead or not. Most of us be medics if we're not squad leads, you know, talk about the guys. And usually we say stuff to him, but if there's no one there to say that, like, you'd get lost.
I'd be
confused. I'd be like, what's going on? Why am I?
Yeah. That's where it comes down to, like, any kind of anybody with has any good experience in here, been here for long enough playing the game to kind of step up and be nice to those new guys. Everybody was new once. I was new once. I was wandering around like that too, wondering how to play some rally at one point.
Yeah, I still remember my first game.
So, like, you just got to jump in, like, especially, like, you'll see toxic players, especially more so with, you know, more people in the game now. There's a little bit more of them.
Bastards.
Inherently, yeah. But
fucking coons.
You just gotta kind of like check them and keep them.
But I've been 99.9% of them have been brilliant. No, you tell them that you've been in a backer. They'll ask you questions all day long. How do you do this? How do you do that? And it's brilliant because you learn by teaching. I've always thought that.
Yeah, definitely.
Little things. But then they'll throw a curveball, and I'm like, they're asking me how do you use the pencil tools properly on the map and all this, and I'm like, shit. Do you know what? I ain't got a clue. I haven't got a clue.
I still don't know myself yet.
Well, there you go. That's what I mean.
Those are just client side anyway, so.
Yeah. Right then, let's move on from the next one. Next big topic at the minute, I think, is hacking in aimbots. Everybody seems to be pissed off with this.
Yeah.
I'm of the...
Bastards.
I just think if there's 100% proof on video, it's permaban. I don't think the devs should go, slap on the wrist, you can't go on the forums. Honestly, pardon my French, but fuck them. I don't think you should get a second chance on this. That's my stance.
I mean, you're always going to get them guys, oh, my brother took on my PC. Like, well, if your brother's, like, you know, able to get a hack on your computer, then good luck to him, because the hack's not just going to be there. Like, I just don't buy it.
Yeah.
I just don't buy that. Like, you know, there's no going back from that. Once you're caught hacking, that's it, man. Like, it's a hard subject,
it depends more on the account name than who's behind it. And if that's up to you to protect your account name. And if someone logs onto your shit and hacks on it, you didn't.
Sorry, man.
You know, you didn't practice. You didn't practice safe account sharing.
Yeah, I won't point at you. I think it was your post, wasn't it, Ian, about 30 days. Was it on the forum?
That 30-day thing was just for the forum itself. As a moderator, I could probably bring you know, a bit more of a unique perspective to this. The thing is, the moderators on the forums, like, being a moderator in the forum doesn't necessarily equate to having any power in-game on OWI official servers. Like, as a 303rd, founder and admin on the servers and everything, I have full rights on those servers. And we kick and ban people like that, and we've actually gotten quite a few compliments lately about people who say, we really like your servers because there's almost always an admin on that's active, and they take care of something right away. You know what I mean? And the thing is, with the OWI servers, it's kind of up in the air. I couldn't even tell you, like, I don't even know off the top of my head, like, who has admin rights there, aside from, like, Melbo.
Yeah.
And the devs, obviously. But, you know, the devs on Reddit today, there was a thread that was made about, someone was like, anti-cheat should be the number one priority. And then there's like three different devs that literally just typed in and said, it is. You know, they're all working on it right now, but it's just, you know, it's, they got a small team of guys, and even that small team of like 20 or so, not all of them have experience in developing anti-cheat. So it's even, you know, you can assume it's an even smaller team of guys that are working on it alongside Easy Anti-Cheat, which is the company or the software that they're going with, you know. So it's, I hate it too, you know. And actually recently the topic came up amongst my community where we're like, well, why don't we just lock a server down and we'll just give out the password to people who want to play and we vet them. So it's almost like a whitelisted server, but not really. I'm just like, you know, I see where you're coming from, but I don't want to like hide away. I almost look at the server as our server as like a way to catch hackers and kick them. Be like, because if we catch somebody, you know, and we ban them, we get their Steam ID. And that's the quickest way to, that's the most surefire way to get their Steam ID, because it logs it in our logs, you know, in the server files. We just go and be like, all right, guys, other server admins, you know, I'm cooperating with other server admins out there. And I'm like, hey, guys, you know, here's this guy's Steam ID. Here's the proof and evidence that we logged. You know, I've compiled a Google Doc sheet with all this info, like time, date, server name, admin name that did it, evidence, details, that, all that sort of stuff.
But do you not think that if, because when you mention it to the devs and say, look, here's an evidence of this guy using a 203, he's firing 30 rounds a second, right? Boop, 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 boop.
Right.
I don't understand why the devs say, we're dealing with it, but we won't discuss it further. If they came out and said, look, this guy, we had proof, community, look at him, he's banned, he can't play this anymore, it'd make a lot of people feel better. I just think they get a little slap on the wrist, like, don't do that again. We'll just create a new account and do it again and again and again.
I mean, historically, OWI has been pretty under wraps about everything that they do, only because they're a smart indie team and they realize that if they get too active in certain contexts, people start to expect things from them and that they might not always be able to deliver on. So, like, that's why they don't come out with release dates, because people start expecting something, and then when, like, oh, shit, we hit this road bump, and then people get pissed, and like, oh, you guys are lying to us, this is a big scam.
Yeah,
you know,
they start...
You know, if they started coming out with, this guy was hacking, we caught him, like, it's more or less, they can't attend to every single one that gets reported, because it is an issue, and there are multiple guys doing it. It's just more or less, like, we're working on it, it's coming, be patient, and then the forum moderators, and then the thing is, the server admins, you know, if you look at all the community ran servers that are out there, like Redcoats, SFSS, FJG, 303rd, all those, they actually outnumber the OWI servers.
I know, they're always bloody full, you can never get on.
Hey, man.
Oh, nostalgia days.
I end up having to play like Australia server with a ping of 500 because I can't get on.
Yeah, so I mean, I completely understand your sentiments, Parup. It's just, I think they're just worried about getting the anti-cheat out as quickly as possible. And they're probably logging this information for themselves somewhere.
Hey, I'm all for them not. I would prefer they didn't say what software or they're doing it so that the hackers don't physically know. I think that's a bad idea, telling them what anti-cheat software they're
using. It would be cool if they came out and made like an actual like thread about it and be like, this is our stance on it. We're going to take it seriously. We're working on it. And anyone who's, you know... It would be cool if they came out and said something like that. I agree. But
I think they're trying to keep it in-house anyway. Like, everything's probably going to be in-house. You know what I mean? It's like, you don't want to give hackers credit for... You know what I mean? Like, they don't want to tell their name. They don't want to...
Yeah.
That's why the forum post, like, everyone was popping it down. And we said to everyone, if you ever catch them... Most of us play on our server anyway. But if you catch them, let one of us know out the door straight away. No questions asked.
You've got to get a video with it.
That's what I said all the time. I would immediately tell people, stop making these threads, stop giving them a wider audience, just report them to me or another moderator, and we will pass it on. And
that's what they're looking for anyways. They're looking for that publicity.
Fucking infamous shit, don't they? They want to be infamous. It's just silly.
Exactly.
Yeah. And this new one that just came up, that guy named Squad Bro, It was his first post, and he posted a link to it. That's like a blatant advertisement for those hacks, you know? I proposed a temp ban for that guy, so we'll see how that goes.
I'm usually suspect when they've got a name, you know, with a load of random characters like 6Ls or 6Is-16, because they know you're never going to remember the name and how to type it properly. I'm always weary of them joining a squad.
That's why Steam ID is great, mate. Steam ID is great.
Well, yeah.
Because you get the Steam ID, they can't do shit.
Yeah, that's why I like having a server. Because, like I said, we can just we can capture them. It's like a trap almost. It's like,
yeah,
you might ruin our fun for 5-10 minutes, but then we have your Steam ID and you're never coming back.
And if they want to rebuy the game, so be it. You'll get caught again. You're just giving money to the developers.
Yeah.
Great.
That's why.
Cool.
That's all I say is thanks for the donation.
Well,
it's really in it. Like.
Right, so I think we're all agreement. They need hanging,
well,
burning,
Doc,
and
Doc
destroying.
No. I was just going to expound on a little bit more, but it's pretty much what you're saying.
Right, now, I was going to talk about, there's a topic, a couple of topics on the forum I've noticed. That was one of them, actually, was the hacking one. The other one is Gore in Steam. And while I'm all for a little bit more of, shall we say, the pink mist, I think that it would be nice if the medics had, say, rubber gloves on. And they actually got bloodied hands throughout the game. And maybe there was slight blood on the floor. We were joking on the forums about when the 50 cal's in. I was hoping that limbs and body parts were going to come off. But really, it's not the right... I don't think it's the right thing for squad. I'm all for putting up a little bit more blood. But I don't want it to become... Well, I think it's just enough. I think that's enough. I don't think limbs should come off.
Well, I'm of the opinion that it should be, should obviously just be a balance between realism and gameplay, and also how much time and effort the devs have to implement into putting in details that aren't necessarily necessary.
Yeah.
You know, I do remember a while back someone talking about there being like a wounded state where you can see your friendly teammates.
I mean, not limping. You mean if you like, get if you take a shot to the leg,
writhing
almost
on the ground,
limping
like
state,
like when they're incapacitated. They're like writhing on the ground, kind of like wiggling around, you know, and like maybe making noise or something where they're kind of like on the ground wiggling or something. And I mean, that would be a cool effect. But then as well as in terms of like injuries in general, I could, you know, I think they implemented the current gore level, as you can call it.
Yeah.
I can see that getting worked on quite a bit in the future. I feel like it's already going to happen. People are like kind of talking about it when a lot of what they're probably talking about, at least the sensible ideas, are most likely going to be seen down the road. Now, I don't have any insider information on this. This is just a hunch.
Yeah.
I feel like we're going to see more of it. But in terms of seeing like dismembered body parts, I don't see that.
I don't think that's
going to
happen.
There's
a borderline there between the actual gameplay itself. The
well, surely
and
that would put the game rating up, wouldn't it? And then there's all the certification stuff, and Germany are just going to turn it into green goo, aren't they?
In that thread, that current thread that's been going on, some people who actually live in Germany or have been, or live in Europe at least, have said that a lot of games nowadays coming out that maybe in the past would have been censored a lot by Germany are now, you know, it's a little bit less. In terms of like gore and stuff, they're still pretty stingy on stuff like drugs or sexual violence or something in games in Germany, but apparently gore is less... You know, they're a little more lenient on it, apparently.
But is it not really how you define gore? Because I think getting shot on a blood pink mist or blood on the floor where the medic's been, I don't see that as gore, really.
No, I don't. I don't see that as gore either. I see like dismembered limbs and like seeing like internal organs. That's when I start thinking gore.
I think
blood. No,
Soldier of Fortune.
This whole gore piece.
Shoot,
I think of like Soldier of Fortune or like Red Orchestra. That's what I'm like imagining that people are looking for.
Right,
that kind of stuff.
Unless they did it with the 50 cal, in place 50 cal, and they just disintegrated. Now, I'm not going to say I wouldn't enjoy that, but like, you know, because the devs have said that they're going to be bringing in IEDs and suicide vests. What they're going to do with the body then? Is it just going to disappear? I presume it will be nothing.
I don't know if suicide vests are an actual thing. I've seen conflicting reports on that, and not.
I believe IEDs are going to be in, but suicide vests.
IEDs,
I think they're up in the air. I'd imagine.
Oh, but can you just imagine if you had, you know, you're playing as the USA, and you had one guy on each squad. Could only respawn every 3 or 4 minutes or whatever. He had a suicide vest, no weapon, and he could sprint faster for 20 seconds. He could run into a compound and blow himself up, massive mushroom cloud. Anders would do his magic with the audio. Oh man,
as
epic.
Always.
Epic.
As always.
I could see it happening. Well, I mean, with a lot of IED blasts, like you see online and stuff, anyway, 90% of what you see is just a big fucking dust cloud.
Yeah, that's all you see. You don't see much.
Yeah. You don't see, I mean, you might see chunks flying out of the cloud, but it's mainly just dust. You know, yeah. So.
Yeah, but we had suicide trucks in PR, didn't we? I remember being at least 100 meters away from this truck thinking this is going to be amazing when it goes into that compound, and I got wiped out. And I was miles away.
That is a huge radius, dude.
Those Gary, yeah, oh yeah.
Gary, yeah, the dumb always fertilizer glorious. Truck.
Yeah.
I think people are very, like, oblivious to the fact that this game's still alpha. Like,
yeah, too.
Exactly.
A lot of people are, like, looking at it thinking, you know, like, we've already had the fucking alpha stage and now this is beta. Like, no.
Yeah,
like,
no.
This game is far from beta. Like,
it's like open
alpha.
It's
very fleshed out alpha.
And it's clearly, exactly. Like, the best FPS out there, no doubt about it. Like, the best military...
Yeah.
Style game you can like the close quarters combat is just
flipping it, Rossi. Know, I can already see crazy. The thumbs down going on this one. Oof.
Oh, well.
Oof.
Well.
Those.
Like you know what I mean. Like COD.
Let's not talk about COD in here. I feel sick.
No, but you know what I mean. Like it's the best mix of them all in one. Like there's no bad thing.
We'll have to throw a push in your pants. Down. Yeah.
Here's something I just want to add about Call of Duty and the new Battlefields. The thing that makes squads so great isn't necessarily just the features themselves. It's how they construct it to encourage people to work together. Yeah. People are still capable of working together in like Call of Duty and Battlefield. It's just so much less prevalent. You know, I think the community doesn't get as much of a good rep as it honestly should because, you know, we could still have millions of people playing this game that just seriously just try and get snipers and just dick around. You know, but it's the community that's like, no. Like, stop doing that, you know? There's so much... Communities can make or break a game, honestly. Mm. And I feel like the community for Squad is such a special and, like unsung thing that should get more rep
attention.
Than it does.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think the community have done a lot.
See, I... You should, sorry, go on, Ross.
I was going to say, it's not on us and them, like, with the devs. It feels like we ain't developing the game, like, clearly, but it's an us mentality.
We've steered
you know?
It.
Yeah,
we
possibly.
Yes, definitely. There's a lot of steering going on. There's a lot of support.
A lot of support.
You know, and it's,
a lot of advertising too, especially from the community itself. I mean, look,
you know,
look we're sitting on the top seller list for so long. I mean, what 2 weeks, I guess. But
name me another indie dev that could come out with a first-person shooter of any kind and be able to tell the community, look, you guys have been playing a while. We need you to help teach the new guys and actually have it happen. You know what I mean?
And everybody's like, gotcha, no problem.
Yeah, how many other communities could do that? I can't think of a single one.
Yeah,
aside
you're probably
somebody.
Right. I mean, I played a lot with 16A, which was a proper, really deep milsim group for Armour 3. You know, proper. They even had ranks and all this stuff in game and all this, and they had proper military guys in there. And well, I loved that for the immersion, man. It got to the point where it was too much. Being forced to play for 6 hours a week. All of it, I needed a break, and then when Squad came along, it just filled that gap for me where there was team play. Graphics and audio were brilliant. Team play, you can get in and play for half an hour, or you can get in and play for 6 hours, as I'm sure Rossi knows.
And you still have fun.
And you still have fun, and every single game's different. And it's like, since getting involved with Squad, I haven't even booted Armour up, honestly.
Me neither.
No, I did, as a matter of fact.
I was running, the thing is, before I started the 303rd, I was running another community, a small one, for Arma 3, and I had a server up for Arma, I had a TeamSpeak server up, we had about maybe 20 guys at the most, and it was fun while it lasted. We actually played one mission of Escape from Altus that lasted 7 hours and 38 minutes or something, and it was some of the most fun I've ever had in my life playing a video game, but just after a while... At least for me, the fidelity of a lot of the CQB stuff, when you'd be out in like the open fields and open areas, that's where Arma really excels for me, is out in these open areas where you're engaging from a distance, because that's fun and that's cool, and you have to worry about how you maneuver your squad and everything. But like in a CQB area, the AI just goes to shit, and they all turn into potatoes.
I just found it too clunky, Arma.
Yeah, it's clunky. And now with Squad, like, I remember back a couple updates ago, we were playing Insurgency, and we had like a mostly 303rd squad together, and we finally got to the point where we were breaching the compound where the fucking cache was, and it's amazing how the focus of what you're doing transitions on a dime, because we were like worried about maneuvering how to get an entire squad level up to this compound. And once we got in there, it was all local chat. And we're like, all right, you're over on that door. We're over on this door. You go left, I go right. And we're all using local. It's just amazing. The fidelity of the CQB is right there with everything else. You know, it doesn't slow down. It's just, it's on point, you know, and obviously it's a work in progress. So you've got maybe some walls or some cover systems that are a little wonky right now, but still it's, it's amazing.
I can only see squad getting better by the time we get tanks, BTR, helicopters, IEDs.
It starts resembling PR a little bit more.
Yeah.
Especially logistics. Logistics is my main deal. Like, that's going to change the game completely. People are going to be playing a totally different game at that point.
Fleshed out cover system, deeper medic system. Free look. That's the only thing I want right now.
Yeah, free look. I just want to press that alt key. Alt key, and I want to look at my feet. Well, a lot of people saying they want the weapon resting, don't they?
That would be nice too, yeah.
I'm going to bitch and moan now because I like to play with the RPK and the saw. I still want less recoil when I'm in prone. Maybe it's just me.
Well, you got to find a place to go prone, dude. I'm telling you, if you find a place to go prone, I mean,
but you look at videos online of the military firing, sometimes they do a full mag, straight through. It does not point at the ceiling when they hold that trigger down.
Right.
It does in game. I think, I don't know, maybe it's just
me. I think what has a lot to do with that is just the weight of the weapon itself is what helps keep, you know, that muzzle climb mitigated. So it's not going straight up. Right now, you know, it's like,
well, it should be burst fire. You only do like rounds of 3 or 4 seconds, stop 3 or 4 seconds, mm-hmm. and if there's a section, then you actually swap, you mirror each other. That's how you do it. Mm-hmm. But I'm just saying, when you hold that trigger down, there's no way it should be pointing at the ceiling when I keep the trigger down.
Yeah.
But anyway, that's another
I'll chalk that up to a work in progress.
Anyway. Yeah, right. Anybody else want to add anything? Because we'll move on. I don't want to keep it too long on this first one.
Yeah.
Right.
We'll move on.
Quickly then. Last one. Suamari map. A few people saying they hate it. When I first played that game, I thought this is, I'm going to say the word, COD. I thought it was a complete and utter clusterfuck until
it is.
Until I got in a game the other night with a squad. We all stuck together. We got on the roofs. We bunkered it up. We got HESCOs around, whatever. And it was absolutely fantastic. We held. I'm gonna stick my neck out here and say we only won that game because of our squad. Everybody else fucked off. They ran around like headless chickens. We stayed up there, we defended, and we had more points than their entire team. So all you have to do is, once you get there, is just cover your angles off. It's CQB. It makes a nice change from the bigger open maps. I wouldn't want to play it all the time, but I actually really like that map.
Yeah,
I know we were discussing this earlier. I know it's a little bit difficult when you're playing on a rant with a bunch of randoms, as this one part. Especially in Suamari, it's so fast and furious and close in like that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you need to trust people. Like,
yeah,
if there's a crew of us guys or whatever, like there's two squads of us, you know that if someone says they're going to be there, they're going to be there. In local, you say, I'm covering your right, and then you just don't even bother looking. You just know they've got your ass. Mm-hmm. It's like with randomers, it's like you've got to go right down to the wire. Like, look at that door. Look at this door. Whereas the people you play with consistently know what you're going to do, and you know what they're going to do. It's just like just the way it is.
You'll see me SL on random servers. I'll say things like 20 times in a row. Because if you don't, somebody's gonna be like, shiny object.
I didn't
the bird
hear
over there, and then they'll wander off halfway across the map. Like, oh,
the same thing.
Bird watching over here at the back corner of the map. Like,
and people are like, yo, we heard you the first time. It's like, well, I bet you
I say it like 16 times.
Jimmy Ballsack over there needs 20 reminders to make sure that he knows what he's supposed to be doing.
Somebody smack him in the back of the head, he's fucking looking the other way. That happens every time.
But that's like the night maps. It seems to be like the night maps. I love the night maps. Seeing it, because obviously, again, I'm playing as usually the support class. Seeing those tracers going flying across, I love it. I cannot remember the last time those night maps were in the rotation.
It's because as soon as night maps come in, mate, the server just empties usually. Like,
such
people
a shame,
just don't
man.
Like them.
Yeah, I mean, I'm not a big fan of Suamari personally, but at times
I don't mind it. It's more of a transition to me.
Yeah.
It's, you know, like it's more of the transition map where people that don't usually play these style of games can jump in there, like, do what they're doing, listen to the squad lead, but kind of do their own thing at the same time. And then they'll start to, you know, develop
kinda
the skills to then play the actual game the way it's meant to be played.
Kind of like a giveaway. I see what you're saying. Yeah.
I've got three things to say about Suamari. First one is, I just straight up avoid it if it's on a slotted server that has like more than 30 people and it's full, because that just becomes, it just becomes too much. As an SL for me, that just becomes too much to try and manage.
No, I agree.
But second thing about Suamari, I like it for the fact that it has, it exemplifies, like I said on the forums in a thread about this, coming from Arma and dealing with the shit fidelity of CQB scenarios, this exemplifies the high fidelity, like the smoothness of how it all can work in CQB. Like, you can lean and you'll actually lean and like it'll actually work. Like in Arma, like you might lean on your end and the guy won't see it, or you might not lean. It's just, you know, like the God, what's that word when two people's computers don't match up right away and he might see you but you're not actually leaning? That's whole
desync. Well, it's not sync.
That desync bullshit. Yeah, exactly. Like, I don't see that ever happening or being much of an issue with squad, you know. And it's so refreshing to be able to actually try and implement some sort of CQB tactics and have them be practical. And that goes into my third thing. The other night, you know, squad in general, in terms of its CQB stuff, when you've got two guys in a compound, we're both watching the doors, you know, or we're watching the same door or something, and we're covering each other. We only have a round of 30. You know, we only have a magazine of 30 rounds. The other night, I was covering a compound, just me and Slippy Cat, and there's an entire enemy squad coming in to attack. They had seen our radio from distance, I'm assuming, because they were running right at us. And I popped my head. I was like, oh, shit. There's like four Americans running right at me through this field. I was like, dude, Slip. Holy shit, dude. They're coming, dude. And so, like, I watched north, and he watched the west door. And I would literally, like, if I told him I was looking away from the door or I had to reload, he would be right on it. You know, like, and in a lot of games, you'll be like, oh, man, I got to reload. Cover me. And you sort of feel like that's just sort of an afterthought. It's like, oh, it's just a video game. That doesn't really matter. But in this game, it actually does. Like, you could be reloading, and they either hear it or they just get lucky, and that's when they push, you know? And your other guy, if he's not covering it, you're screwed. If he's not covering it, you can't shoot. They'll pop you, and then he'll be like, oh, shit. He'll react slow, and then he's done.
Well,
it's just a split-second thing.
The ability, you can play randomly, or you can play as much tactics as you want in this game, I think. When I squad lead, if I'm going into a compound and it's flat, I get the saw gunner to go in first. I always get the medics to be at the back. And sometimes if we're going into a compound and there are hills around the side, you know, where you can look in, then I'll send the saw gunner and the 203 gunner up onto the top. Then we'll go in. So it's there if you want it. Mm-hmm. Totally there if you want it.
That's the beauty of squad, you know. They leave it open for you to strategize, and those people who do coordinate and strategize, they're normally the ones who take the win, and those are the people that deserve to win.
Almost always. Play better, yeah, I doubt.
Almost always. Every single time.
Yeah. Yep. I think a really good topic for the next one would be strategy in general, because we've been talking a lot about that over the 303rd, and I've come up with some good thoughts about overall team strats, especially.
Don't give your secrets away.
Oh, no, I won't.
Everybody's going to end up doing it.
The enemy.
Let's just give them a little flavour. A little flavour, yeah.
1v1, bruv.
Just undo your dressing gown, yeah, and just give them a little bit of a tidbit. That's all the community needs. Right, well, I'll wrap it up there then. Unless there's anything else. Sorry, I didn't mean to interrupt. Go on.
Oh, no. Maybe also more SL tactics, working as an SL or working as a certain role instead of squad. That it could be kind of good for some people to glean off of.
Definitely.
Yeah, interesting. Right, well, I'll wrap it up then. Thanks for turning up. Today we've had Redcoats Rossi, DocEast, Ironxbay, and the Knobhead myself, Para. This has been our first version of RallyPoint, our squad podcast. Like it, leave it, thumbs up, subscribe, all that usual. And if it's popular, we're probably going to end up doing another one. But in the meantime, I'd like to thank all the lads here, all the regulars, the founders, the backers, and the devs. Let's get onto the battlefield and smash some heads. See you in the next video. Bye-bye.
So we're all for now.
Yep, see you.
Ta-ta.
Ta-ta.